Henry, and I have a presentation today. The project is aimed at determining the performance of the two companies in terms of accounting of finance for product growth employed by each company. To conduct the license steel case and the regular private corporation companies were selected as the project operational M&A as evaluating the financial health of the company. The license is a 4-year study from 2015 to 2018. The first section provides a brief description of the two companies and what the product produce and the service they offer. The Steelcase company manages the report as steady growth. The company has shown an outstanding performance in some of the financial area. But the management of the company needs to ensure that they focus on all the aspects of financial performance so as to close the gap and make the amount that is the management of the company in the world. The goals of the management objectives has continued to plan the supply from 2015 to 2017 until it reached a new milestone, which was 33.46%. This means that the company made a good profit compared to earlier years. In 2018, the profit declined started to 32.93%. Regal Payroll Corporation gross profit margin throughout the year has mentioned a ratio of 26%. With the smaller firms, the ratio has been fluctuating and it is lower than that of the SCS means that the SCS makes a good profit in terms of net sales compared to its competitors. The market expansion of SCS will the profit up and the company cost of goods sold sold greater than that of RBC. Return on assets. This is an indicator of all the funds that are invested in companies' assets and their ability to generate return. A firm needs to have a good return. On assessment that it's possible for the company to grant an idle ratio in 4 years, 21.69 and 41.67 and 18.79, all in percentage, while that of its simple comparator is 23.69.81. From the post president, one can tell that the ROIA of RBC is good as the company has a higher ratio, and the ratio has showed continued improvement over the period from 2015 to 2018. Return to equity. This marks the certain factor of corporation of net income or profit that is generated from the company's shareholders' investment. SCS return on equity almost doubled up from 12.73% in 2015 to 23.83% in 2016. In 2017, the ratio dropped to 16.26, and it continued to decline in the following year to 10.03. This is in coincidence, the amount is higher than that of RBC, which were 1.56 and 7.6 and 9.9 in 2015 and 2016 and 2017 as well, and also 2018. Therefore, the company is able to provide more returns to investors as they are facility and effectively utilizing its quality. The declining trend experiences resulted from a higher increase in shareholders when compared to the net income. Net profit margin. This ratio is a factor of a firm's efficiency in managing its expenses, resulting in net income. While seeing on the above table, we can conclude that the revenue, net income, and the expenses are not consistent. The company net income and the expenses are floating year after year, hence our net profit margin that is not specific to security. The net profit margin SCS net profit was 2.76%, and it is it rose by 2.69%. This resulted from increases in revenue and in 2017 and 2018. The company net profit dropped as a result of a high cost of expenses incurred by the company, as recorded, and upturn in the net profit margin, and this is a positive sign. In the near future, Steeltex needs to focus on ways of increasing the company net profit margin. Operation to profit margin. Starting from 6.06%, the value increased to 6.56 in 2016 and 6.77 in 2017. In 2018, there was a drop by 1.66%. Because the pilot corporation increased to 9.48%, and then jumped to 9.94. The ratio has increased to 9.84, it increased to 10.2. Looking at the two companies, RPC has a higher operation profit margin, meaning that the company is creating more profits from its operation. Earning per share. Earning per share are the value of the earning from individual outstanding compared share. It is compared by the dividend company earning after taxes by the number of the compared share. From the table over the last 4 years, RBC earning per share has an increasing trend. The ratio improved from 3.18 in 2018 to 5.76 in the year 2018. Two increasing the earning after tax for SCS share income was only 0.68 in 2015, and in 2016 the ratio increased to 1.36. Later in the remaining year of the period, the ratio reduced to 0.68. This is an factor of the negative result from the SCS. Now I will talk about the price and earnings. This ratio is a factor of the market willing to pay for the company's earnings. In addition, it also measure whether the share price of the company is overvalued and undervalued or very good. From 2014 to 2018, the result compression ratio was 18.50, 32, 16, 16, and 13.32. Respectively, the ratio has been because CTS TA was 17.43 and the ratio plummeted to 9.22 in the brown year. In the remaining year of the period, there was an improvement in the ratio. SCS had a high ratio compared to its comparator expect in the year 2016 when the company considered less risky investment for investors. In the remaining year, investors considered bidding up the steel's case price as a result of the offered profit and has for possible future prospects. The key ratio and the factors compared profitability and the liquidity and also capital. In conclusion, the key ratios that affects compares profitability and the liquidity and also the capital structure have been discussed extensively in this report. In addition, other financial ratios had that give an insight of the company's preference have been analyzed and interpreted with the period of 4 years. It is found that since tax years and February were part of the legal comparisons in December. This is that the preference of the two companies may be affected by the fact that they are not in the same sector. Both being in the middle and in the through. Of course, this Steel's case has been in the milks. Marks for a long time, there are some of the flaws that are observed at the company management consensus in the specific area and goal, such as the legacy and the evaluation. The capital, the capital structure of the both companies is statutory as the company are principled using capital from a equity conveyor to debit to debit. So we can report conclude that Steel case is a factory report and the interesting by engineering that they produce quality goods and service to sales and at the same time meaning it's accessible. The company is the company has an in place policy that has ensured that performance is outstanding. They are offering the distinct products and they give the science based property. By analysis, the financial statement using ratio analysis is shown that the company performance in clothing in some years and periods. On the other hand, Regal is a potential organization which can use the fund 1 and 2 position. The company management needs to improve on their asset management skills and also on the property ratio, especially on operation manager and evaluation. This reference was the major objective of the study. Finally, I believe that SCS will consistent to their profitability more by maintaining a customer value and goodwill in order to prevent market leadership in the financial design and the manufacturing sector. Thank you so much for listening to me.